Howdy and welcome to a Photoshop tutorial brought to you by Infinitouch.com. In this one we're going to be showing you how to add muscle to your sports picture. I just brought up a picture of this cool football player playing football. Ha! Just kidding. It's a picture of me. But I mean, like, I am still cool, so like whatever. Anyway, as you can see in this picture, my left arm's looking kind of shrimpy. So don't worry, I've been in the weight room since then and I'm looking a lot better. But as far as the purposes of this picture goes, you can't do anything about my muscle back then, but you can do what you can do in Photoshop to make it look bigger. So the first step of doing this is we're going to have to go to the layers and unlock the background layer. Now that it's unlocked, we can work on it, and we can head on over to the filter option and go on down to Liguify. This is where we're going to be doing all the work in this one. So to begin, we're going to start using the forward warp tool. The forward warp tool is a way that people in the industry like to make models look skinnier, per se. And you can do that like by pushing down the waistline of models and stuff. But we're not going to do that today. For us, we're going to make my biceps look bigger. So let's lower the brush size a little bit. And you can see my settings right here. Brush density 100 and brush pressure 100. The brush size, just choose whichever will work for you. Usually a bigger size lets you get a fuller looking and it doesn't look as distorted. So let's zoom in on this muscle. So just in case we don't want to be working on the muscle and hitting the stomach here, so what you can do to avoid this is using the freeze mask tool. Anything you freeze mask over, it will make sure that the forward warp tool won't affect it. So we're going to go over that and make sure it doesn't get in the jersey or get too far into the grass here. Okay, now that we've freezed over that stuff, let's start doing the work with the forward warp tool. Let's just slightly work on the triceps to begin this. Just nice and easy, pushing them out. You don't want to make it look unrealistic. Because if you make your muscles look bigger on a picture and it looks unrealistic and you upload it to Facebook, people aren't going to be having it. And then they're going to think every picture that you look good in, that you went in and altered it. So what you want to do is make it look realistic and look strong, but not too strong. Getting a little forearm work here. I don't know what they're going to think I did to make my forearms look so big. But it's whatever. Now we can get in the bicep, the beach body muscle. Just nice and easy pushing it out. You want to work on the edge here, and you want to make sure that your direction is perpendicular to the angle of the muscle you're working on, because if you work parallel, even though you can make it push out wider, you're bringing the whole tricep down with it, and it makes it look droopy and not good. So you want to make sure you're working on a perpendicular angle. And you can play around with it. Obviously, you're going to focus on it more than I am for the purposes of teaching you how. But that's good on that muscle. And let's head on over to my right bicep now. Now, what you really don't want to do is mess with the shape of the football, because that's just the first cue of photo altering. So we're going to put that freeze mask tool over the football so the football will retain its shape. Also a little bit over my chest so that doesn't get altered. Let's just push it out just a tad. Let's work on the tricep just a little bit. You want to make sure the shape is consistent and there's not any big jumps. A little bit on the forearm. Whoops, not that much. Just nice and easy. Nothing too big. And one thing I dislike about these jerseys of ours, these are away jerseys, they're a little too loose. So one thing you can do to make it look like we have cooler jerseys is to bump the jersey in a little bit. You can change the brush size for a more full look and it's not too concentrated on one area. And you know, let's just go ahead and do it to this shoulder as well. And if you want to erase the freeze mask tool, use the thaw mask tool to thaw it out. Then you can get working on pushing that shoulder in. It's just a loose jersey we're working with here. And you know, another part of the body that has a little loose of a jersey is the abdomen here. I want to make it look like the jersey is a little more tight fitting. So let's erase the freeze tool. And let's make sure that the warp tool doesn't affect my biceps, since we just made that all good. We also don't want it hitting the towel or going too far into the body. So let's work in the abs here. You can change the brush size to a lower brush size if you want to focus on a particular point. That's looking pretty good here. So let's see what we have. Race thawing out all the freeze mask layer. Biceps looking bigger. Looks like the jersey's more tight along the abs and the shoulders. And the bicep on this side was looking good as well. And the football retained its shape because we put the freeze mask layer over it. So that's looking pretty good. And let's push OK. Now if I was doing this for real and I wasn't just doing it to teach you, I would probably spend a little more time on it to make sure the edges look a little bit better, like on this jersey, and maybe smooth out a little bit of the bicep here again. But while you're working on it, you can focus on what you need to focus on for your projects. One last thing I want to do is to make this left arm look a little bit more defined. I want to use a little dodge tool on it. Not the dodge tool, actually, the burn tool. I'm going to change the exposure to about 25%, so it's real light. And the shadow, the range, change it from midtones to shadows, so it adds in the definition. Right there, just makes it a little more darker to make it look a little more defined, so the muscle looks good and the color didn't get changed during the liquify process. So it's looking pretty good now. And just to show you how it looks different compared to the original, I'm going to make a new layer and bring in the original picture. Line that up good. Now that the original's picture is in, we can compare it. This is the original right now, and this is the new one. With a bigger arm and the shoulders of the jersey and the abs of the jersey are more brought in. Muscle looks bigger on the right bicep as well. And there's not much distortion on the grass around it. So I think it's looking pretty good. And now I can upload it to my Facebook and everybody can think I had big muscles during this year of football. But anyway, I hope you liked it and I hope it works good on your pictures. But thanks for watching. And be sure to subscribe to the Infinitouch YouTube channel for more sick Photoshop tutorials like this one.